It's okay.
Where's the firework?
People are being idiots.
Hey, it's okay. You can see it on the video.
What's the outro?
Isn't this illegal? You're fine. Oh, whenever there's something going on, I was supposed to be a party.
Is there any more?
Is this a snack?
Heck.
Why did they stop?
I hope they did.
Oh, I like those things.
Let me see if they're going again.
I will hear it, and I will come see you.
Here we go. Stop. Stop, Abby. Get in bed.
I want to see fireworks.
Get in bed.
I want to see the fireworks.
Get in bed.
I want to see the fireworks.
Get in bed now.
I'm getting in bed, but I can't see the fireworks.
Can you go again, Wyatt?
What happened?
Is the camera good? Is the camera good again?
$10 for every minute we're late. You're probably just getting antsy.
So I was meeting up in Minneapolis with my YouTube friend Tim Tom because flying for 8 hours on your own isn't very fun. But it's the first time we met IRL and he's super cool. And he's tall. He's really tall for a bicycle. On our flight there were a bunch of funny things we entertained ourselves with. One of which included Tim being a nerd and hacking one of the little airport app games with a program he made on his computer to cheat and give him all the answers. It was the one that gives you a random assortment of letters and you have to make all the words you can out of them. So we got to Amsterdam after a long flight and you know, I never really understood jet lag until then. Every emotion is like exponentially enhanced. We were tired, things were dizzy, our brains didn't work, everything was hilarious. We were so hungry that when we got something to eat, it was like the friggin' best thing we've ever and will ever have in our lives, even though it was just a dumb bagel. And it didn't help that everything was in a language that we couldn't understand. Dutch is probably, to an English speaker, one of the weirdest languages to look at. It looks just enough like English at a quick glance, but then you stop and try to read it, and it's like, wait, something's not making sense here. What are you even trying to communicate here? It looks like a 2-year-old just smacked the keyboard a bunch of times. Now here's the story that'll live on in infamy, the rice cooker incident. So to try and save money and think ahead, I decided to buy a travel rice cooker to be able to make some quick meals in the hotel room in case we can't find food sometime during the trip. We picked up a few groceries, and when we got back to the room, we realized the hotel didn't give us anything. There wasn't a fridge, there wasn't water, we didn't have a chair, the frickin' shower didn't even have a door to it. So there were two problems at hand. First of all, what are we gonna do with all this produce without a fridge? And second, how are we gonna prepare it? We started trying to get innovative and think of things in the room we could cut produce with. What if we sharpen our credit cards? But we ended up going down to the lobby and stealing a butter knife. I don't know how people can rob banks and jewelry stores, but considering that butter knife was enough to make me break into a nervous sweat. And literally, no one cared if it was on. It's probably a bit of a time saver for them because it's one less bit to clean. We got back to the room without being caught because we're master high slayers, but noticed, wait, we don't have anything to cut stuff on. So then we had to be even more resourceful and use a tour guide's coupon booklet they gave us as a makeshift cutting board. It was the most scrappy, sad kitchen setup probably ever. Tim tweeted a picture of it. Sorry, Gordon Ramsay. Some people probably would have given up at this point and said it wasn't worth it, but it was too late to go back. We sold for this meal. We were in too deep. After laboring for way too long over cutting onions and peppers with a dull butter knife on a soggy tour guide that got shredded paper on everything, it was finally time to plug in the rice cooker and make everything worth it. We put all the ingredients in the cooker, plugged it into the wall, and all the power went out. Uh-oh. We blew the ring fuse. The little rice cooker was too powerful for Europe, I guess. Tim and I shuffled down to the front desk and were like, so, all our lights went out, and yeah. They were really apologetic, even though we were kind of the ones who stole a butter knife from them and used it to blow their ring fuse, and ended up transferring us to one of their comfort suites. At first, we were like, ooh, but it was pretty much the exact same thing, but with a bit more space, a chair, and a smaller window. And still no door for the shower. Also, life hack? Use a tiny rice cooker to blow a hotel fuse and get transferred to a comfort suite for free? After all that, we were definitely not gonna risk blowing another fuse, so we had to get rid of the evidence by flushing the ingredients down the toilet. We didn't deserve to be in that hotel. Our only other option, other than just starving to death, was trying to find random food places on our own. It was my job to find places to eat, and it was pretty much dragging Tim to these obscure places that you'd normally try to avoid. I was using this app that showed where food spots were, but it took us to really random hole-in-the-wall places that, like, no one's ever heard of. Tim probably thinks I'm a total weirdo. We were trying to be nice and all, oh yeah, this place is interesting, as we, like, sat on a bench with no shoes eating lukewarm vegetable pieces. Anyway, we were there for VidCon Europe. I don't know if you picked up on that or not. I was invited to be a moderator on an animation panel with Susie, Tomska, and this really nice girl, Ditta. Since I'm a nervous wreck when it comes to these things, I accidentally dragged Tim into areas he wasn't allowed because he didn't have a speaker pass. I was just ruining everything for him. But the panel was a lot of fun, and I didn't mess it up for everyone else, so that's a relief. After VidCon, we decided to visit Paris, since it's like right there. But we had a hard time getting there, and I got kicked out of the train station bathroom because I didn't know how anything worked and was an idiot. And when we actually got to Paris, we were scammed immediately. But besides all that, it was great. Paris is like way prettier than you would think. Like, everything's so pretty, it looks fake. But it's not. Because it's Paris. While we were walking to the Eiffel Tower, there was this sketchy street lady who was do you want from me? I still have no idea what happened. So the last day of our vacation, we were winding down from all the adventures we had, but I had one mission. Redemption. I wanted to find one final restaurant that wasn't weird to make it up to Tim because I'm a horrible friend who drags people.